Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And I got me a box. Yes, and you've seen the title of this video. This box should contain a Creality Endor 3 3D printer. A new printer by Creality. You might have come across it. And you also might know that I had a CR10 before this one. This is a slightly smaller printer, not tiny, but slightly smaller. And the price of this printer is incredibly low, in my opinion. In this video, I'll switch to a fully built printer. More on that in a second. I'll give you my first impressions and we'll do a first test print with it as well. Now, again, I won't be building the printer in this video. I'll have a separate video and there will probably be a link up there to my built video of the Endor 3 by Creality. In this video, again, I'll show you the printer, its details, give you my first impressions, and we'll do a first test print. So let's switch by the power of YouTube to a fully built printer. Okay, so we have a fully built printer and it actually works, which is not unimportant, of course, and I'm very happy about that. Now, let me first do a short recap of the build, what I've made of the build, how easy or difficult it was. If you've seen my build video, you've probably seen that I didn't really ran into any snags. The only thing difficult was that the motor, the Z-drive motor, which is behind this left pillar over here, it is screwed to this pillar with two screws, and the build instructions didn't say which screws to use. Yeah, and okay, that was the only real difficulty, and it wasn't all that difficult. I had two options for those screws and both would have worked. So, okay, everything else, I think Creality really has this frame build thing method down. This works. It was easy to get rid of any play. I now have no play in the bed, and in the nozzle carriage there's no play anywhere. So that was nice, and yeah, the spool holder is on top over here. On a smaller printer like this, it might not be as big of a problem than on bigger printers. Okay, what more can I tell you? Yeah, the printer, instead of the CR10, has bigger thumb screws, wheels really, to adjust the corner heights, or to do the bed leveling, right? So it's far easier to grip onto these. This is definitely an improvement. So that is very nice. There's not much more to tell about the build. It would take you approximately half an hour, I'd say. It took me hours because I was shooting a video. But well, if I wouldn't have been shooting a video, it would have taken me approximately half an hour. 20 minutes, half an hour. There is slightly more building involved than in the CR10. In case you are familiar with the CR10. Slightly more in the CR10, at least the CR10 I had, this entire top structure, the uprights and the horizontal carriage, was a one piece. I'm not sure if that's the case, if, for instance, if you get it from Gearbest or other vendors, there might be kits which come less assembled. And yeah, so this top structure on my Endor 3, I had to assemble myself. Yeah, I had to put the wagon on, I had to put the belt which drives this wagon I had to put that on, this tensioner. I had to put this screen on and the power supply, which is over here. I had to put this end stop on, sensor over here. I think on the CR10 you also have to attach the sensor yourself. So there is a little bit more building involved in this Ender 3, but again, I mean it when I say a little. And if you have two hands and half a brain, you won't have a problem assembling this here printer. So that's very nice. Okay, what comes with this Ender 3? At least how I got it, and again, I got it from Banggood. This is what I got with the printer. I got me a spatula, a scraper, which is slightly narrower than the one that I got with the CR10. I would have preferred the one that I got with the CR10. This one's a little narrow. It does work, but well, okay. You get a pair of side cutters, which I think is exactly the same as with the CR10, and they work just fine. You get some tie wraps to tuck wires away on your printer. You get another spool of filament. You get a length of filament, which was actually not enough to print the sample dog that comes with the printer. This is how far I got, approximately half half a dog. It looks more like a torus. It did print well, by the way. More on that in a second. Okay, so and this is what I have left after trying to print the dog. You get yourself a memory card adapter, USB thing, memory card reader, and you get a memory card, which is nice. It is actually an 8 GB memory card, which is more than enough. 4 GB would have been enough, 2 GB would probably have been enough. On the memory card you will find manuals, build instructions, all kinds of manuals, a slicer. I haven't really looked through it. Probably more or less the same as with the CR10. You also get a spare nozzle and extruder. I'm not sure what these are called. The brass thing on the extruder and the metal thing on your nozzle. So you get spares of those. With the CR10, or at least the CR10 I got, the second nozzle had a different diameter. A smaller diameter, if I'm not mistaken. However, this extra nozzle isn't specified on the product page at Banggood. And does it say on the nozzle what the size is? No, I can't see any specifications of it. I am assuming that it's the same 0.4 mm nozzle. And so, a spare. You get a bunch of tools, hex drivers, some wrenches and a screwdriver. The hex drivers are actually nice. One end has a rounded tip, so you can screw things in at an angle. So yeah, that's actually very nice. And after build you are left with quite a bunch of extra screws. Spares, maybe to attach accessories. I do not know. Let's call them spares. And you get build instructions, which you have probably seen by now in my build video. A 12-step build instruction sheet, which worked fine. Again, apart from that one time Step 4, where it didn't tell me which screws to use. Other than that, very nice. Okay, so review time. Obviously, I just got this printer. I have done a number of prints with it by now. And what are my findings so far? The bed. As you know, the CR10 and a lot of other printers come with a glass bed. This Ender 3 has, Build-Tec. It's not genuine Build-Tec. I've never actually seen Build-Tec in the flesh, but you shouldn't have to use glue on this bed, and you definitely don't need to use tape on this bed. Actually, the CR10 comes with tape. This one doesn't come with tape, which is telling, of course. So far, I've been pretty impressed with this surface. It works very well. I do, so far, start all my prints with a heated bed. Yes, it does have a heated bed. And I heat it up to 50 degrees. After the first three layers, I shut down the heating of the bed. My printing so far has been done with the first three layers at 200 degrees PLA, the rest of the layers at 180 degrees. So far so good, that works. After the print, it is pretty hard to get the print off of the bed. Not impossible though. Most times I can just break it off. Or make a start with the spatula, but actually it's easier to break it off. So again, you don't want to have your prints come loose, obviously. And in that sense, so far so good. And again, I have used this spatula with anger actually a few times, and as you can see, my build plate still looks fine. And this is only after approximately 5 prints, so it doesn't say a whole lot, but it's definitely not very fragile. So that is nice. You can't take it off. It is permanently attached to the bed, which is a metal plate, and it's not bendable either. Yeah, that would have been very, very nice, but not something you'd expect at the price of this printer. Tell me if I'm mistaken, but that's my take on things. At the price of this printer, I didn't expect the bed to come off and be bendable. It has one benefit, by the way. There aren't clips holding your glass plate on, so the entire bed should more or less be usable. Is that true? Yeah, that's actually true. Yeah. So with the CR10 you've got those clips, which makes a part of the bed unusable. No such thing with this bed. Very, very nice. Okay, and for this part I need to rotate the printer around. What Creality did at this end is an improvement as well. This plastic piece, which holds on to this mesh wire, protects that wire, and that was kind of missing on the CR10, right? A lot of people made 3D printable additions for the CR10 to protect your wires over here. This printer comes with those pre-installed. That is very nice. Now over here, at the top of the lead screw, might be a little dark. Over here, the lead screw isn't supported by a piece protruding from the horizontal bar. As you can see though, it's actually pretty hard to move. Yes, my Z-axis is halfway up. Let's move it down and see what things look like then. Well, as you can tell, there is a little bit of a play, but not to the point that I'd say it needs a support. I actually wonder if the amount of play you see here has any effect on the printer's ability to print precisely. Okay, on the right side of our printer, attached to the riser, you see the power supply with an on-off switch. This thing looks a bit bare-boned. Maybe it's appropriate for the price of printer we have here. But yeah, I'm not sure. It looks a bit industrial. That's not really the right word. Unfinished, maybe. Again, maybe it's appropriate for the price of printer we have here. And I'd rather have this and have the printer print very well than the opposite. Have the printing quality leaving to be desired and have this look good. But it's obviously up to you. That's my thought on this thing. It is, by the way, handy that it's attached to the printer. If you have to move your printer, you can simply unplug it and take it away. That's definitely easier than with the CR10 and a lot of other printers which have a separate control box. And the same goes for the control panel, of course. It's attached to the printer. Yes, you won't be able to see that now, but it has an exposed back. You can touch the electronics. No high voltage current over there. But again, I might go ahead and print me a cover for that. Okay, the heating of our bed is done. The nozzle has been preheated and our printer is printing. Cool. Okay, and as you can see, I'm pretty close to the printer. It is not very loud at all. You should easily be able to pick up what I am saying instead of hearing the printer. You can hear it. You'll probably be able to hear the printer. And I'd say it's no louder or quieter than the CR10. More or less the same. Now, if you'd have this printer in your bedroom, you will have a hard time sleeping with the printer. You should probably never run a 3D printer in your bedroom anyway. But if you'd have this on your desk, you can definitely still work at that same desk. So that's nice. And yeah, so my first findings on the printer, right? That's kind of it. I could tell you that the printer is wonderful and super duper, you should get one. But I haven't got a lot of experience with the printer so far. So far, I am personally happy with my purchase. It works very well. It is well made, especially for what it costs. I would have paid more for this printer, actually. It is very, very sturdy. This kind of framing works. Now, I have actually never tried to print in ABS. And as you can tell, this printer does not have an enclosure. So ABS, I really don't know. Maybe you have experience with printing ABS on your CR10. Let me know in the comment section below if you do. I'd be interested in hearing that. And I'll be doing more videos on this printer, a longer term review. I'll probably also do a video on printing flexible filaments with this printer, if that works out well. I am personally very interested in that as well, because the extruder looks a little different from the CR10. Better, actually. There is less gap between the feeder rolls and the inlet. I'm not sure what the feeder block, I don't know. But this should, in theory, from the looks of it, work better than the CR10 for flexible filaments. I'll let you know in a future video. If you are interested in that, don't forget to subscribe, of course. And with that, I'll leave you with thanking you for your time. Hope it was informative. If you are left with questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comment section below. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.